something a little different here. It's the old classic Edelbrock Performer RPM. They probably sold a million of these fucking things. Put on your Mahler type engines. These are good, damn good intakes. This one's an older one. Dead old though. Probably 10 years maybe. It's a non-air gap. These things look kind of like the old LT1. Z28 350 intake from back in 70-71. It's more or less with the pattern that I'm after. There's another intake though. These are some of the best dual planes. But most engines I build, I use single plane intakes, but if I'm building something milder, one I built customers shit, and they were wanting cruiser type, you know, they wasn't wanting 700-800 horse engine. So a lot of these Performer RPMs fit the bill. This one here is going on an engine I'm building for my wife. It's going in a big 5,000 pound fucking Suburban. So it needs all the torque it can get. But that other intake I was referring to was the old Holley Street Dominator dual plane. Those things were one of the best, if not the best, dual plane ever made. But Holley quit making them years ago, and they're getting kind of hard to find now. That's what I was looking for when I found this unit. Late 70s, early 80s, Holley Street Dominator dual planes. They pretty much look just like a LT1 intake, except they say Holley and shit on them. But you get the ones that were winners castings with the snowflake on it. That's who cast GM's aluminum intakes. So the Holley intakes were cast at the same foundry as the fucking high performance GM intakes. So that was the better quality of them. These intakes here, everybody wants the fucking air gap. You know, they look cool, I guess, for a dual plane. But on a dyno, there's not much power difference, really. The main power difference on them is the air gap has this center divider here milled down. But if you run an inch spacer on these motherfuckers, you don't need to mill it down. So one of these with a 1-inch spacer pretty much matched the power of the air gap without a spacer. And the engine this is going on, it's not going for every last little fucking horsepower. It's going to be a good 400 to 425 horse unit, maybe 450 plus pounds of torque. That'll be plenty to get that Suburban moving. That's your main difference right there, though. Fucking take about half an inch out right there. Back in the old days, GM, like the L88 427s and shit, came factory like that. They used a big aluminum high-rise intake, but they'd mill them down, make it act kind of like a single plane, but have the low-end manners of a dual plane. These phenolic spacers isolate the carb from the heat. These are a heated intake, except the heads that's going on are unheated. They're fucking dark 180 Iron Eagles. But if you were putting one of these on stock heads, it's best to block that heat crossover off, unless you live in the Antarctic or somewhere. It's where we live. It don't get that fucking cold. I don't even have chokes on none of my shit. I use big unheated single plane isolated runner intakes on everything I have, so shit works fine. Even when it's 10 degrees outside, I still go out and start my shit up and take off as needed. But some people just a little more peculiar about shit, and it's all about how much you can tolerate. The fucking cars I've drove over the years, like my truck, for example, your average person wouldn't even know how to fucking drive it. You know, get beyond the manual transmission aspect of it, and the manual brakes, and the manual steering, and the fucking Detroit locker rear end that ratchets around corners and shit. And it's got a clutch in it. It's a solid puck racing clutch in it with no springs and shit. It's just solid disc with six ceramic disc or pucks on it. So it's fucking, it's either on or it's off. It's pretty grabby. If you ain't used to it, stall that motherfucker out pretty easy. But it's all what you get used to and what you can tolerate. None of my vehicles have AC or radios or heaters or power steering or power brakes or any creature comforts whatsoever. Just don't fucking, in my world, I don't need that shit. And if I'm feeling like a real big pussy, we have a minivan sitting out in the driveway that I feel funny driving it. But if you're gonna have a driveway full of race cars, you gotta have at least one regular vehicle. But I don't need no shit like that. I drive my hot rods year round. There it is.